Hi everybody, it's Laura here from Making Cards is Fun, and today I am part of the Save the Crafty YouTuber video hub hosted by Justine Hovey. This video hub is a celebration of card making video tutorials created by a group of talented crafters, and I'm so excited and honored to be part of this. Simply watch and like the videos, consider subscribing to our channels, and click the link in the video description below to hop to the next video. There are over 50 prizes to be won throughout the video hop, and I am giving away a $25 gift certificate to lawnfun.com. Make sure to leave a comment on my video by June 5th for a chance to win. The giveaway winners will be announced June 10th on Justine's channel and blog. A big thank you to LawnFun for sponsoring this giveaway. For today's video, I decided to create a magic picture changer card featuring the brand new Peacock Before and After set from LawnFun. Let's get started. I am starting out with two pieces of White Nina 80-pound cardstock, and I'm going to stamp the peacocks on each piece of paper. So for my first piece over here, I am stamping the peacock without showing his feathers. And then for my second piece, I am stamping the peacock that is showing his beautiful, gorgeous feathers. I'm using Memento Tuxedo Black ink since this ink works really great with Copic sketch markers. To color the peacock, I am laying down the BGO2 color first to make sure that these colors are going to blend nicely. Because I usually have a little bit of trouble to blend blue shades smoothly, so that's why I am laying down that color first. Then I also use BGO9 and BGO7. To color the peacock's feet and beak, I am using YR16 and YR21. And then I'm going to color this peacock's body using the same color. So I'm using BGO9, BGO7, and BGO2. For his feathers, I'm using YG17, YG25, and YG03. I also used those shades of green to color the other peacocks, so I didn't show that on camera because I used the exact same colors and the exact same technique. Then to color those things on his feathers, I'm not sure how you call that, the pattern on his feathers, I suppose. I'm using BGO9 and BGO2, and then I'm also going to add in some purple. I'm using V15 and VO1 to do so. Next, I'm stamping the two peacocks on some masking paper from Simon Says Stamp using Memento Tuxedo Black ink. And then I'm using my EK Success Color Bee scissors to cut out these shapes. You can also use a post-it note to create your masks or even printer paper. Whatever works best for you and whatever you have in your stash. Now that I cut out my masks, it's time to cover up the colored peacocks and to do some ink blending. I'm using some Heffy Doodle low-tack tape to mask off my sky and grass. So first I'm going to color the grass using Twisted Citron Distress Oxide ink, and I'm using some really inexpensive makeup brushes to blend this color. I find that these makeup brushes work even better than the mini ink blending tools from Ranger. It's even easier and smoother to ink blend your Distress Oxide inks. Alright, so I peeled off my mask and then it's time to ink blend the sky. Before switching over to the Tumbled Glass ink pad, I cleaned off my brush by rubbing it onto a chamois and then a Kleenex. It's time to create the Magic Picture Changer card. I am using the Magic Picture Changer die-cut set from LawnFun to create this beautiful interactive card. And I die-cut the two main panels, and now I am folding along the scored lines with my bone folder. Next, I'm going to apply some tape adhesive to both of the sides. My tape adhesive was a little bit too white, but that's okay. I'm just going to use my scissors to trim that down a little bit and to cut it to the perfect size. I guess you could also use liquid adhesive or just a tape runner, but I find that the tape adhesive works a little bit easier for this particular design. Now that I applied my tape adhesive to both sides, I'm using my bone folder just to burnish that adhesive tape, and then I am removing the backer sheets on the backside of my magic picture changer cart, and then I'm going to fold those little tabs in the backside of the die. Before we move on to the next step, I'm going to apply some kitchen flour all over my magic picture changer card to make sure that it will slide easily. Now it's time to assemble the magic picture changer card. So I am sliding the tab into the main pocket, and then I'm going to insert the tabs into the slots. I slowed this down a little bit so you could see it more easily. I have another video on how to create a magic picture changer card, and I will link it right here so you can go ahead and watch that, because I explain, or in that video, I explain this technique a little bit more in depth. So now that I inserted those tabs into the slots, I flipped over my slider card, and then I adhered the moving piece between the two traps. I removed the adhesive backer sheets, and then I close it all up. Here I am using the Magic Picture Changer add-on die to create a riddle frame for my Magic Picture Changer cart. I used some pattern paper from the Really Rainbow collection from L'Enfant, as well as from the Really Rainbow Scallops paper pad from L'Enfant. I wanted to decorate that the little tab that you pull out, so I did some partial die cutting. So as you can see, I just lined up that die with the edge of my cutting mat, so I didn't have to waste any pattern paper. And then I'm using my Tana guillotine to trim that down, and then it will be the perfect size to cover up the little thing that you pull up. Okay, so now I'm going to do some more die cutting. I'm using the pull tab from the add-on die cut set from L'Enfant, and then some of that Really Rainbow pattern paper. I wanted to have the inside of this little pull tab to be white, so I'm using my Tonic Nouveau Smooth Precision adhesive pen and some white cardstock to cover that up, because on the back side of that tab it had a green pattern on there, and I didn't want that to be green, I wanted it to be white, so that's why I'm doing this. I'm also going to adhere that really, really tiny little piece that comes with the P die. So I saved that when I die cut it. So make sure to keep those little pieces, because you will need that little thing over there to finish off that P. Next, I'm going to use some of my Scotch ADG to adhere or to decorate the little pull tab with my pattern paper, and then I'm also going to adhere the little die cut using that same adhesive. And I had so much fun combining these different patterns from the different collections from L'Enfant, and it was the first time I used some 12x12 paper from L'Enfant, but I actually enjoyed it because sometimes it can be fun to combine different sizes. So sometimes you want smaller patterns and then some larger patterns for a nice balance. I am using the fancy wavy banner dies from L'Enfant to create a fun banner for my sentiment. I die cut one of the banners out of some pattern paper, and then I die cut one of them out of white cardstock. I am using some of that adhesive from the Tonic Nouveau Smooth Precision adhesive pen to adhere that frame. And then I am using the Wavy Banner Saying stamp set from L'Enfant to stamp my congratulations sentiment. I'm also using the Peacock Before and After stamp set and some Memento Textile Black ink to stamp the rest of the sentiments. So this card will say, "Congratulations, you must be proud as a peacock." So I just love how these sentiments can be combined to create your own greeting. I'm using a pencil to mark down where I have to add my adhesive for my Magic Picture Changer card, and then I'm using my ADG from scotch to add that adhesive. Then I can adhere my little frame on top of my magic picture changer, and I just love this purple and blue gradient. I think it's so pretty. Here you can see that my magic picture changer works and it changes nicely. I had a little bit of trouble at first because I adhered that pattern paper on my little pull tab, but in the end it worked out fine. I'm adhering my congratulations banner using some foam adhesive, and then I die cut a white rectangle using the large stitched rectangles I could set from Lanvin out of some white cardstock. I adhered that to my magic picture changer, and then I'm adhering the finished piece with some foam adhesive to a standard size note card. That's it for now. Thank you so much for watching and enjoy this video hop. Bye bye.